Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. How are you doing this evening? I need some more life than that. How are you doing this evening? Fabulous. Welcome to the Futures of Fashion, everyone. And we're going to start off by opening this show with a fabulous, legendary runway walker from our ballroom scene community. And ladies and gentlemen, give him first a round of applause, because I would like to introduce the legendary one and only Twiggy Poochie Golf Song. Please clear the way. Please clear the way. We have a legend walking through the building. Please clear the way. I need everyone to give it up for the legend, Twiggy Poochie Golf Song. Show some love, darling. Y'all know what to do. Give it up for the legend. Give it up for the legend. And definitely the work that you've been doing in your community. This is the legend, Twiggy Poochie Golf Song.
Welcome to the Future of Fashion Experience. Give yourselves a round of applause. I have the esteemed pleasure of welcoming the group that brings this to you, Team AI.
Hey there. Hi, everyone. My name is Rachel Goslins. I have the honor of being the director of the Arts and Industries Building. And I just wanted to welcome you to the Future of Fashion here at the Futures Exhibition, the first ever exhibition about the future on the National Mall. Y'all look amazing and so shiny. I'm going to have to take a picture. Hold on. This is literally why I brought my camera on stage. Oh, my God. Oh, wait. No, that's a video. Shit. There we go. All right. You guys look amazing. I see you, and I see you, and I see you over there, and those pants, and that skirt, and oh, my goodness. So one of the best things about doing an exhibition about the future, which I hope you all have a chance to wander through if you haven't been here already. Who's already been to this exhibition? I love to see that. All right, so one of the best things about doing this kind of thing is that it gives us an excuse to invite the most fantastic, most fabulous, most fun, most smart, most interesting people we can think of to come down to the Smithsonian and the National Mall and help us imagine a future that we want to live in. We've been doing this since we opened. We're going to continue doing it through 4th of July weekend, after which we close. Come back, check us out for our other programs. But this one is really special. When the programming team mentioned this to me as an idea in their heads, gosh, like a few months ago, I was so excited. I've been looking forward to this night since then. I want to give a shout out to the amazing programming team at the Arts and Industries Building who puts these together. Donnie and Andre, our programming team, are amazing. And I'd like to throw it over to them to kickstart the evening. Thanks so much and have a great time.
Rocking the fashions that we all dream.
Rocking the fashions that we all dream.
Yeah, say we rocks the party that rocks the party. Yeah, rocking the fashions that we all dream. Yo, are y'all ready for this Into the Future of Fashion Experience? Give it up. Listen, my name is... name is Andre Latil Watkins. I am the lead of public programs and community engagement here at the Arts and Industries Building. Don't I look fly, y'all? And then I got...
I'm Donnie English. I'm the programs manager here at the Arts and Industry Building. I know I look amazing, so you don't even have to tell me.
Listen, y'all, this is the Into the Future of Fashion experience. And if you got registered, I'm so glad that you're here because I had a whole bunch of people hit me up in text saying, I'm trying to get in. We were completely sold out. So give it up for yourselves for signing up early. And once again, give it up for our director, Rachel Goslins.
Oh, give it up for Rachel.
Listen, I need y'all to do me a favor. Take your phones out real quick, just real quick, real quick. Let me see them in the air. Put them in the air real quick. Let me see them. I need you to follow us at Smithsonian AIB. Smithsonian AIB. And this is the way that you keep up with all of the latest and greatest events. Me and Donnie be putting together some amazing stuff. Right, Donnie?
I mean, they know. They're here.
Listen, so this evening experience is going to include an amazing panel. It's also going to include a futuristic runway experience. And I see a few of y'all that have some super dope outfits on, so don't be surprised if I pull you up for an interview. This experience is being live streamed, so we want to make sure that we thank our sponsor, NBC Comcast. Give it up for NBC Comcast. We also want to shout out our partner, HBO Max's Legendary, who has their third season of Legendary that's going to be premiering next week. Give it up! All right, so let's introduce our panelists. Donnie? Oh, I go first. Okay, here we go. All right, so I want to make sure that we call up our panelists to the stage. We're going to have an amazing conversation about the future of fashion and what that looks like, feels like to them. So let's call our panelists up. Come on to the stage.
Give them a welcome. Give them
clap it up,
a
clap it
welcome.
Up.
Keep it clapping.
Yes, let me hear y'all. Come on, y'all. Let's affirm them. Don't they look so fly? Yes. Excellent. Y'all can go ahead and have a seat. Amazing. So first up, we have Michelle Chow. Give it up. Yeah. I mean, oh, my God, that outfit is so fire. Michelle Chow is the founder and CEO of Avantgardist, an e-commerce platform providing convenient access to underrepresented, hard-to-find, innovative designers from different parts of the world. Give it up for Michelle. Michelle.
Next, we have Mr. Andrew Noel. He has over 10 years of industry experience and has been featured in Harlem's fashion show, BET's On Fashion, BET's Rip the Runway, Philly Fashion Show, District of Fashion, and New York Fashion Week. Andrew Noel has had his work featured in Harper's Bazaar, Elle Magazine, Beast, Hype Beast, and more. Clap it up for Mr. Andrew Noel.
Yeah. We also have Marnie Sinofonte. Marnie is a style artisan, clothing designer, creative director, and television personality. Her work is featured through editorial spreads in the most important fashion magazines of the world, Vogue, Harper's Bazaar, WWD, NYT, Elle, V, Essence, and many more. Give it up, y'all. Y'all just had to take a pause. I get it. It was a lie. I understand. Who we got next?
These accolades are crazy up here on the stage. Okay. Next, we have Mr. Jack Mizrahi. Clap it up.
Give it up for Jack.
This 29-year veteran of the famed ballroom community, known as the voice of the ballroom scene, Mizrahi is revered for his services as the master of ceremony across the nation and abroad.
Revered. We also have Deshaun Wesley, y'all. Yeah? Deshaun Wesley is our moderator MC for the evening. Deshaun is an actor, choreographer, dancer, and host of Legendary, an HBO Max original series. He is a prominent member of the ballroom community and is known for his unique dramatic style of Vogue. He has also appeared on the FX series Pose as an actor. Give it up for Pose, y'all. Consultant and choreographer. Yo, are y'all ready for this conversation? Let me hear you. All right, Deshaun, let's get this party started.
Oh, yes. How are we doing out there, everyone? Okay, we're again, welcome to the future of fashion. Again, we just want to make sure we get as much information as we can by speaking to this fabulous panel of fabulous designers and those who are into the fashion, those who even made a change or are still making a change within it. We want to make sure we ask some questions, get some information, and you know, move forward with what we see in our vision with this, okay? So I got some questions. We're going to ask our panelists to see what's going on, and let's get this thing started, okay? And don't worry about my smooth voice. It'll get smoother. Okay. So, again, I just got a few questions I'm going to ask everyone, and we're going to have an opportunity to see as well as get the answers and the vision of where our panelists have come from, definitely with everything that's happening here. So let me – I got to see my beautiful eyes. So I would like to ask the panel a question. It's open and everyone can take it as soon as you want to, whoever can take it. So what is an existing challenge in the world of fashion you are most passionate about solving? And anyone can answer this question.
I'm passionate in a lot of things, but the one that I really want to solve is democratizing, you know, the access to incredible designers from around the world, and making it available to anybody, regardless of who they are.
Thank you, Michelle.
I concur. Yes, I think now that we have social media, before, I mean, when we were started in fashion, we didn't really have social media, and we didn't have access to the world, and we just had a very finite amount of designers that we were shown in magazines. And we had to find young designers on our own and of all different colors, ethnicities, everything. So it's really an amazing time now. And I think that's one of the things that I am very passionate about, is finding young talent, giving them a platform, and giving them the bodies to be able to show their work.
I do want to kind of go back real quick and ask Michelle one quick question. So are you working with anyone to help you kind of like reconcile this challenge or this change that's going on?
Well, I'm working with a world of independent fashion designers, which include a Japanese designer under my platform, Yasuyuki Ishii, who will be showing his incredible pieces to you all today.
I want to ask you the same question as well, you know, about the inspiration, about, like, again, who are you working with to help you reconcile, like, these challenges that's happening?
I am working with, some projects going on right now that I can't really talk about too much about, but, oh, excuse me, hello.
Yes, okay.
Gorgeous. lost my train of thought.
Okay, me too, darling, me too.
Oh, yes. That should light up. Right now I'm working, I have a bunch of projects that I'm working on right now that actually one of the young designers that I met on my show, I was able to hire them to do some work for Ivy Park, for the Adidas Ivy Park collection that I do. So whenever I, and our it's so funny, one of our contestants last year who didn't make it to the end, I ended up using him for something recently too, on a project too. So I love, like, you know, seeing these new young designers and whatnot, and then trying to bring them all along the way. So
the opportunity to grow, I think that's beautiful. question still open. If anybody wants to take.
Taking note from what the both of them had said, it's about accessibility as well, right? Being able to access it. Like, I'm wearing this today because I grew up loving Dapper Dan, right? Reading Word Up magazine, and inclusion is a big thing, and it didn't take until we put the umbrella from HBO Max's Legendary that people started coming to our community. Our community has been fueling fashion for a long time and said, hey, let's collab. So I think it's accessibility and definitely a lot of collaborations.
Same with you, Jack. So who are you working with to help reconcile these challenges? Or is there someone like, you know?
I love to work from within our community. I love to champion all of the kids that put their heart out into creating different looks. looks like. You'll see me this week at the legendary premiere. I'll be wearing something by our community member, and I think in the spotlight that we're in now, it is, you know, it is our duty to start highlighting them, bring them up as well.
Let this one go around.
All right. Well, for me, it's just taking, it's just the process of creating. You know, it's just looking at fabric, just taking this still material and shaping it into something, you know, something I think would be wonderful and great and that my customer, you know, could appreciate. It's just that whole creative process. That's the exciting thing for me, just looking at it, just a bolt of fabric, and then at the end is this actual design, this three-dimensional design that, you know, my customers say, hey, you know, I like this. This makes me feel good.
And as well, can you are you working, who are you working with? Or are you doing anything to help reconcile these challenges? So, you know.
Well, right now I'm working with a group of young men of color. I'm teaching them pattern making, sewing skills, and things of that nature. You know, there are a lot of, unfortunately, D.C. doesn't have a design school. I went to FIT in New York City. So these young men would find me on Instagram and say, hey, you know, can you teach me how to sew? Can you teach me how to pattern make? And, you know, I believe in giving back. So that's something that I'm doing right now, working with this young group of men.
Please don't mind if I do this. You know, I can't clap at the moment, so this is my clapping, darling, okay? I would like to move on and ask a question. This is leading more towards Marnie and Michelle. I want to talk about sustainable fashion, okay? So, oh, you're welcome, darling. Let's figure out some answers then. Well, researchers have shared that the fashion industry plays a major role in climate change. Yeah. So what makes fashion sustainable, and how is the fashion industry moving towards sustainable future? So anyone can take that if you're ready for it.
Yeah, sure. There's one that it's being talked a lot about is closed loop systems where regenerating materials from pieces that's been used until the value is no longer retained, and then it's going back to biosphere when there's no use of it. So I think that's something where we are headed to, and I'm targeting looking for designers also supporting sustainability in any way. Some of them use like upcycling, and there's, you know, a lot of coloring process. How they make the garment also is very important to protect our globe, you know, for generations to come.
I think that upcycling is probably one of the things that myself and the people that I've been working with have been doing the most of, where, you know, there's so much vintage, unfortunately, fast fashion kind of out there in the world that we need to reuse it and repurpose it, and we just can't keep buying and throwing away and buying and throwing away. So it's really important. And all of the designers on the hype recently, it's amazing. There's so many of them whose lines are based on upcycling. So I feel good about the future. I feel good that the young people and young designers are acknowledging it and doing their part in trying to minimize waste.
Thank you so much. Hey, am I good? Okay, fabulous. All right. Well, I do want to take, let's take a look into the future of fashion by, this is a face featured by designer Avante Gardist, correct? And Michelle, we wanted you to tell us a little about this design, so let's have an opportunity to see this fabulous design.
Oh, yeah, this Avante Gardist. Incredible piece is created by Yasuyuki Ishii. It was fusion between technology and fashion, which is what we're heading towards in AI, Web3, and Metaverse. This piece is a first piece. It's for sample, but the future production ones will be utilizing the closed loop system, which will be using reuse feather, so it won't be used for new feather to.
What was that? A used feather?
No, in the future it will be used for use feather, like down inside the jacket. This is
down,
a geometry
like
down
okay.
long jacket.
So cool.
Yeah.
So how does it exemplify the future of fashion that you dream of? How does this exemplify the future of fashion that you dream?
This geometry is giving you like the imagination of what it forms and present itself in different form that conventional do not present.
And it looks extremely multifunctional.
No, Sade.
Yeah, this is incredible.
Yeah, it looks like the sleeves come off. It looks like it's a vest. It's a coat.
Yeah.
It's a dress. It's a dress.
It's a it come
it's
through. I see. I'm into it. Cause, you know, listen. I think we should move with the next question, which is basically like opens up for everyone as well here as well too. Thank you so much, by the way. So, in your own specialty field, how do you imagine an inclusive future in fashion to look in the year like 2070? I'll repeat that again. In your specialty field, how do you imagine an inclusive future in fashion to look in the year 2070?
I think it is going to be in the Web3 metaverse, we are integrating the virtual and real world to bring people closer together. If you're looking at today, going from, fashion show to retail, is not very direct and connecting to the consumer. But in the future, I think all the designers will be able to present themselves directly with the consumers in the metaverse.
By the way, the metaverse is coming in, baby.
So you're saying the avatars are going to be done in 2070? Head to toe.
It will be called extended reality, where you are living in the virtual world.
Well, I'll speak on the reality because...
No, tell me the reality of it, baby.
I still haven't gotten quite into the metaverse yet. I'm trying. But I think the reality of fashion and inclusivity, I do see a shift in, gender norms, and I just don't believe that there's going to be male and female clothing, and I don't believe in sizes, and I don't believe... I truly believe that fashion is going to take a fluidity of sorts that is completely unbiased, I should say. Like, I truly believe that we're going to probably do away with, definitely I believe in 40 years we'll be doing away with male and female clothing, I think.
All right, well, let's move it on to the next question, too. But I want to lead this one with Jack. So, Jack, I want to ask you a question. Share some ideas on how you believe the future of the fashion industry would change if gender and body mass were non-existent.
First of all, it's going to make sure everybody can look how they want to look, feel how they want to look, right? Feel how they want to feel and not be worried about being judged. I think it's going to make Fashion Week shorter. It's going to be maybe Fashion Day, right? Lord knows we don't need all that. I'm going to get the same hate mails. But I think what it is, it's going to just emphasize what inclusion really means. It's going to be something for everyone and anyone, and there won't be any lines to tell you don't belong, you can't, and you shouldn't.
Thank you. Okay, let's ask a question for everyone. Let's talk about cultural appropriation versus cultural appreciation. And I definitely come from a community where we are being appropriated quite a lot, but we are taking back our fight with this. So, but I would like to ask a question for everyone. As the future in fashion moves forward, how do designers and industry experts celebrate the authenticity of cultures without appropriating? And this is open up to everyone, so.
I believe it's about interacting and understanding of other culture instead of taking of its face value and copying it. You really have to understand the culture and, you know, its adaptability and, you know, and flexibility. And like myself, I was born in Hong Kong and live in the U.S., and it's all about adapting to the culture where I'm at, and I think it's all about understanding.
Yeah, I think it's I think education is the most important part of this, and because I feel like sometimes people maybe appropriating when they really mean appreciate. You know what I mean? So I do think that there are, it's a tough line right now, and I just think the more that we can educate ourselves on different cultures and especially their fashion in culture and especially what things mean to different cultures and where it came from and whatnot, and the more we can educate ourselves, the more that we can then appreciate and then, you know, if we choose to tap into it or not, at least you're understanding what you're doing. So.
Yes, and I would piggyback off what Michelle said. I think it really is having a great appreciation for the culture that you're looking at. You can be inspired by the culture, but not to actually take an item from that culture and treat it like an accessory on a runway and, you know, just diminish it that way. I think it's just getting in there, understanding what the culture is about. And again, you can be inspired by it, you know, in a respectful way.
Well, I hear the bell, but I know how dogs feel now. But no, I just want to say also, it's inclusion again, right? And it's not just going out there and say, we love your culture, we appreciate it, but why don't we explore the culture by letting the people who are indigenous to that culture, let them design, let them sew, well, not just sew, because that'll start a whole other problem, but let them design, let's get the information from them, let's not just put it out there and say, you know, we appreciate it, but let it come organically from that community or from that culture.
Absolutely.
Oh, well, fabulous. Well, let's take another look back into the future of fashion, and this is a face by designer Andrew Noel. Fabulous. So, Andrew, give us, you know, a reaction to this piece.
So, this is a tailored piece that I put together. It's a silk jacquard evening coat with pants. Actually, it's women's wear fabric, and I just started to work with women's wear fabric recently. I mean, it's challenging in working with that and creating a tailored look. And the chain vest was, I took a trip to Home Depot one day, and I just saw this chain, and I said, let me see what I can do with this. And that's what I came up with, you know, after 8 hours of draping. So it's just trying to move, you know, menswear forward and to be creative at the same time. So
I do have another question. You know, I know you kind of tapped into it, but I want you to, like, give me, like, how does it exemplify the future of fashion that you envision and dream of?
For me, it's changing the silhouette, and it's using fabrics that was, you know, that was just reserved for women's wear. This is an actual women's wear fabric. It's a silk a jacquard fabric, and it's not something that you would really see in a lot of men's wear designs. So again, you know, we talk about how, you know, we look to other genders for influence and things of that nature, and to create something that's genderless. This is me taking a step out in that direction. you know, so that you won't, so one day there won't be women's wear fabrics and men's wear fabrics, it'll just be fabrics.
Yes, God. Yes. Okay, so I do want to lead this conversation real quick, or this quick question with Michelle, excuse me. So I would love to ask, so what technology trends are influencing the fashion industry that you recently or currently excited about today? So like, how does technology trends influence the fashion industry today?
Well, I'm excited about 3D, Metaverse, and Web3. As you know, I keep mentioning it. I really think the future is about how you are democratizing the beautiful creations in different form, in different environment that is very direct without relying on major social media platform like Facebook or IG. You know, they can represent themselves in the tech stack.
That does lead to my next question, which is like, how do you envision the power of social media impacting the way we shop in the next 50 years? Because no Sade, we tend to go to social media real quick when we see something we like, compared to what you buy, then what you get. So let's talk about how do you envision the power of social media impacting the way we shop in the next 50 years? So this is open up to everyone. Anyone? I'll ask again, how do you envision the power of social media impacting the way that we shop for the next 50 years?
I don't think there will be social media. I mean, they would
tell
be,
me.
They would be a virtual world. Like, people can socialize and entertaining with friends from Japan or China. It doesn't need to be physical, right? And I don't think they will exist in 2070.
That's the truth. Anyone else?
It's going to get expensive, okay? You think about it, social media, if everybody wants to be an influencer. You're constantly taking photos. You can't be seen in the same thing more than once or twice. Like, I stand with Tiffany Haddish with the white dress, right? Because it gets incredibly expensive. As we get into more and more different type of social media things that we're going to do, people are going to want to impress and look better and change it constantly. Yes, we're going to go to the metaverse and that's going to change it, but I think until we get there, people are going to start looking for more designers. They're going to hashtag and highlight more designers. Their girlfriend can make them a shirt, and next thing you know, you could probably, buy that shirt or dress one of your famous clients in it. But I think it's going to give you more access to people, to designers, and to style. It's going to change how we look at style.
I will say that social media has been the only avenue that has been able to help us find this talent. I mean, we never saw it in any of the major magazines, and I only knew Dapper Dan from exactly.
What a magazine?
No, not even. Like, honestly, Puff Daddy told me to go get something made from Dapper Dan, and I had to call him, and I met him at 3 o'clock in the morning in the middle of, it was nuts. So I'm saying, I think that social media is important. I think the metaverse is the future. But I do believe that it's right now one of the only outlets where I'm able to find new talent. Like, my algorithm is like bananas, it's crazy what I find. But I am finding all of the new talent that I'm using on social media right now.
And I think it's also is a democratized fashion. There are no longer any gatekeepers. The magazines don't
right.
say who's hot and who's not.
Exactly.
You could just go on social media, and if you have a great product and you can connect with tribe of people, you can be successful and make an impact in fashion, as so many designers have done recently. So it's great for that also.
For real.
Fabulous. I mean, I would open this up one last question before we push on to the next design and style. What makes you hopeful about the future of fashion from your field? Open to everyone.
I hope it will be inclusive. And, you know, it's really for everybody in the future. It's, you know, regardless of your geographic locations or color or ability or disability or sexual orientation, it's all about everyone. It's us. That's what I want the future to be.
For me, that's the best.
It's all good, baby.
Sorry. That's the most hopeful. That's what's so exciting about the future of fashion. For, you don't have to go, I mean, obviously, you went to FIT, but you don't have to go to, you know, you don't have to put yourself in debt to be able to do something that you love to do. You know, like, you have a platform now. You have an audience. We can look at your resume. You don't have to go through LinkedIn or anything anymore to get something in front of my eyes, just the same way that I'm finding, like, in a million years, you know, like, we weren't able to just get so close and have such access to who we wanted to have access to. And now we do, and it's really, I think, the most important and the most exciting thing about our industry now, because it's not just the fashion that I'm finding. I'm finding illustrators. I'm finding animators. I'm finding assistants. I'm finding just so many different people and parts of the of our art of fashion that goes into it that I would have never even found a pattern maker. But I watch TikTok and I see all these pattern makers. I'm like, oh my God, they really know how to cut a bias. Like, call them up. Like. So I think that social media is imperative, especially for right now.
So. Oh, baby, and we still got more to go. Oh, because the internet plays a major part. But let's take a final look into the future of fashion, everyone. This is a face by designer, True Face by Grace, okay? Darling, I'm speechless. All right, this is for us in the discussion as a whole of us on stage. So let's give us a reaction about this piece. What do you see? How do you feel? Let's talk about it, y'all. Everyone, I mean, besides the model, let's talk about this piece here.
She is eating it.
Yes.
Y'all can give her a bigger round of applause than that. They are eating this look.
And True Face by Grace could not be here, but we're going to have a quick discussion just so you know about what's happening in front of us. So anyone, open up.
I mean, it's beautiful.
What can we say? It's mind-blowing. We are speechless up here. Like,
really is. Not just the actual accoutrements and the beadwork and everything, but, I mean, the makeup. The girl, the people that did the hair back there, it's like mini sculptures. It's really.
And it's so simple, but it's so regal. And all that simplicity, you know, you felt royalty standing here in front of you.
Absolutely.
I'd go pick up my kids in school in that.
Jack, I'm not sure if I want you to pick up your kids in him. Okay, ladies and gentlemen. First, let's thank our panel of prestigious, wonderful people here, Michelle, Andrew, Marnie, and Jack. Thank you so much for having us sit down and talk and chat with us. It's been freaking amazing. So give them a round of applause, everyone.
Thank you. Thank you, guys. Thank you so much.
And it's been friggin' awesome. So before we get up off this stage, I do would love to call on here. Oh, my gosh. We love this. Oh, my God. We love this one. Andre, please get up here with you and Donnie. So we can move forward. Y'all know Andre come with some energy. Oh, yes, Andre. Thank you, panel.
Test. There we go. Remember to chant after me. Repeat after me. We rocks the party that rocks the party. Yeah. Rocking the fashions that we all dream. One more time. We rocks the party that rocks the party. Yeah, rocking the fashions that we all dream. What y'all think about that panel, y'all? Listen, the night is not over. We're just getting started. Listen, the panel was dope. but we still got our runway, our futuristic runway show that's going to be happening. Donnie.
All right, so that means we have to clear out this space, and we have to allow for us to reset the runway. So as we end out this panel conversation, please make your way to the rotunda, grab a couple of drinks, dance for a few, and then we will make another announcement. Don't forget to purchase our merchandise from our vending machine back there. But please enjoy the evening, and we will call you back.
Rocking the fashions that we all dream.
Are you ready for this fashion show, y'all? Donnie, what we got, girl?
All right. As we introduce the curator of this show, I first want to acknowledge our runway commentators. We have Miss Najla of Durdu Fashion Wear. Who else we got?
Who else we got? We got Deshaun Wesley in the house, y'all!
And last but not least, we have the Jack Mizrahi.
The icon?
After the end of each show, we'll hear a few commentary from them about how they feel about these pieces. Now, please remember, all hands, feet, back, arms, back, chest, back. We gotta have good posture, guys. Okay.
Donnie, real quick. I just want to thank y'all so much, number one, for coming, but also for your patience as we turned over our stage. Give it up for your patience. Give it up for your patience. All right, Donnie, go ahead.
All right. The woman of the hour, the curator of this whole entire fashion show, is Miss Rokoy Clark of Studio Couture. Where you at, Ro?
I'm here. Hey. What up, everybody? What's going on?
Make some noise.
Woo! So I know you guys have been seeing me walking around already, so it's like a reintroduction. So, hi. Hello. Are y'all ready for the future of fashion? All right. We gotta do a little runway etiquette. So you guys all know, we've got our models coming out of the runway. I just wanna make sure we have a nice, smooth runway for them to walk down on. So please make sure we're not having our legs and feet too far out so that way they can sashay left and right down the runway. They're gonna pose right here. So please make sure you guys give them some space, especially down here. All my people to my left, all my people to my right. Please make sure you guys scoot those feet in
scoot
and give
those
our
feet.
Models some space to walk. I just want to shout out everybody who's been such an amazing part of this show. My name is Rokoy. I'm the owner of Studio Couture. A lot of you probably have come to my last Smithsonian show, District of Fashion. Was anybody there from here? There? Yeah, and so I'm excited to be back at another Smithsonian, bringing you guys the future of fashion. We have some amazing designers here. One of them, Yasuyuki Ishii, has flown all the way from Japan to be here for you guys tonight to show an amazing collection. I want y'all to show some love for DJ Aurelia. Give it up for DJ Aurelia on the ones and twos. So I want y'all to really show some love to all of these models from all walks of life, different ethnicities, shades, shapes, colors. So many different things you probably are not used to seeing on the runway. I want all of you to see it, love it, embrace it, and I hope you guys see yourselves and a lot of these models on the runway. Are you guys ready for the future of fashion? Yeah. All right, DJ Aurelia, are you ready? True Face by Grace. Spend love,
You guys, give it up for Mimi Tao from Project Runway.
Shows up by some indoors, I'm a male performer. Wow, Shoot, 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 sh
Give it up for True Face by Grace. DJ Aurelia, let's queue up for Kaylee Shelton from Marymount University.
All right, Toxic Darling.
Yes, I love it.
Loving the looks. Loving it.
Give him a round of applause, everybody. Yes. Come on.
Come on.
That was beautiful.
Hi, Whitney. So which look were you living for?
The PVC coat with feather trim. Fabulous.
Oh, you call it a PVC coat?
I'm assuming that's the material that was used. Either way, it was absolutely gorgeous.
I love it.
Are they? Okay, we're good.
Up next. Vincent Lee, avant-gardist.
While this is all happening, everyone, you will be hearing our commentary, so be up for our beautiful voices.
Give it up for Vincent Lee.
Thank you.
I can't hear you guys. Give it up for Vincent Lee.
Yes, yes, yes.
Work, 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 work.
Yes.
The prince, the looks, the attitudes, and the rocks is nasty.
I completely agree. It's beautiful.
Look, I normally say this to guys in gray sweatpants, but I love the prince.
Oh, wow. Gotta love the print.
Serious. Ladies and gentlemen, don't forget Legendary Season 3 premieres on HBO Max May 19.
Joey Jet with Jet Brand.
Thank you.
That's a whole lot of attitude in this collection. Yeah. Even the cherry blossoms look menacing.
And I'm definitely a fan of black and white and clothes. It just does, it's so rich to me. I just love it. Who doesn't look good in black?
Y'all give it up for Joey Jett with Jett Brand. All right. Up next, Natalie Abrams.
And culture.
It's all about the jewelry on this one.
And culture.
Yes. Give them a yes.
One time with Natalie Abrams.
Y'all did that.
Natalie, that was great.
Y'all did that.
I need that red cuff.
Definitely. Real elegant. Elegant.
Yes. Y'all.
Can y'all give it up one more time for Natalie Abrams? Up next, Andrew Noel.
Thank you.
Tell you what, I'm going to wear to the Emmys this year.
No Sade.
That was fabulous. Give him a round of applause, y'all.
Yes, one time for Andrew Noel.
Yes, Andrew Noel.
Andrew, that was really good. I really like the black numbers.
All right, we're going to hit you guys with something a little special. Shout out to our special celebrity guests from The Hype in the building. And HBO Legendary. Can y'all give it up for our special VIP guests? So we have a special treat. We have a couple of looks from the show, The Hype, from a few of their finalists on the show. So if you watch the show, you might recognize some of these looks. So DJ Aurelia, give me some beats for The Hype.
Statement. Legend, statement, star. Said you wanna be a legend, or statement, or star. Said you wanna be a legend, said you wanna be a statement, said you wanna be a star. No, we're legendary.
Legendary.
I'm so, all I really wanna be is an icon or a statement. No, it's legendary. Baby, walk me down. Baby, walk for me. Let me see you vogue for me. Let me see you shrug for me. Walk it down, then pose for me. Baby, walk for me. Walk for me. I'm so, all I really wanna be is an icon or a statement. No, it's legendary. I'm so, all I really wanna be is an icon or a statement. No, it's legendary. Walk for me. 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 Serve, walk,
walk.
I'm so, all I really wanna be is an icon or a statement. No, it's legendary. I'm so, all I really wanna be is an icon or a statement. No, it's legendary. your hips. Runway girls, are you that bitch? And don't you forget that dip and performance. You are now. Duck walk and show them how you break it down. Serve it on the floor for me. What's your score? Judges, please. I'm legendary, legendary. I'm legendary, legendary. I'm legendary, legendary. And I really wanna be. Oh, I'm legendary, legendary. I'm legendary, legendary. I'm legendary, legendary. But I really wanna be. I don't wanna get high.
it up for the hype. Up next, we have Phenotype Setter from Avantgardist. Thank you.
center.
Yes, give it up, people. Wake up, Miss Singh. This is not golf.
Beautiful collection.
Beautiful collection.
Yes. Thank you, Michelle. Beautiful collection.
You
love
work.
This.
Different use of shape.
Yes. Shapes and layers for me.
Have to agree.
We are in our last two designers, and we have to present Yasuyuki Ishii all the way from Japan. He has a method to his madness. So we want to make sure he can show it off. All right, give it up for Yasuyuki Ishii and Avant-Gardist.
Thank you.
Yasuyuki. Oh my gosh. Yes, whoa. Yes, 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 yes.
Yes, and
all right. Types of
you
yeses.
Do that.
Yes, yes.
They did that.
Yasuyuki Ishii. This was the one. No Sade.
Our finale, our final designer of the evening, we have Frank Hun.
Thank you.
Yeah, bring it down here. This was a great line.
Absolutely gorgeous.
That red dress is everything.
It is.
Frank, this is great. Y'all give him a round of applause, y'all.
Thank you so much.